6 Sierra Papa, pushing, see ya.
Pushing 6 Sierra Papa, district guard, stay with me.
We're with you, 6 Sierra Papa.
I'm good. Flight controls.
Flight controls.
Thank you.
Sure.
320. And our track is 321, so we're good.
So we're flying the needle.
Yep, you're right.
This is 6 Sierra Papa, traffic 1 o'clock, 3 miles, opposite direction, helicopter altitude indicates 5,900.
8,500?
Looking for that traffic, 6 Sierra. Looking for traffic, 6 Sierra Papa, you said that was 5,500?
This is 6 Sierra Papa, 1 o'clock, 3 miles, altitude indicates 5,900.
Okay. We're above them.
Roger that, looking for traffic.
Cessna 6 Sierra Papa, it appears you turn towards direct traffic, no factor for exchange proof. Good day.
6 Sierra Papa, switching, thanks.
You do it.
You're
good at it. I think that's him over there. But
yeah, he said 2 1 o'clock, 3 o'clock, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright. Yeah, that's about right.
Alright, so we're right over Drake.
I don't know, are we?
I think so. 0.7.
So you're getting a deflection. You're inside 1 mile, so don't chase it.
Yeah.
Keep your heading.
Yep.
Okay, what are we going to turn to, though?
300. We want the 350 outbound.
Okay.
So we want to turn... Waypoint. Cool.
Yeah, it's because we're going to Drake.
Yep. Should be about 20 seconds. I'm going to make that turn.
Wait for the flag flip.
Wait for the flag flip before you turn?
When we're flying VOR, you wait for the flag flip.
Copy.
Otherwise, how do you know we're directly for you?
Okay. Yeah, and in that case, if I would have turned early, I would have been...
There, it's between.
Okay.
Now you got flag flip, now you can turn. Now, if you have like the GPS and you get the turn anticipation, yeah, you can do that.
Yeah.
But for right now, I want you to cross and then turn. But know that we... The radial is directly out of it, so we might have to have to turn back. So initially turn to your heading, and then make corrections. Alright,
we're looking at 12 DME.
12 DME.
That was 2783, contact Flagstaff Tower 134.55.
That approach is going to be fun to listen to.
So initially fly that heading, and we're close, so we just had the flag flip, so it might take a little bit for that to come back in.
Okay, yeah.
So don't get too aggressive trying to chase it initially, because
right.
We're only at 1.3.
Yep. We could be in the complete cone of silence.
So it's okay if you leave a little correction in there, because you know we flew past initially, but don't go wild past.
Yeah, I wasn't going to go more than 5 degrees, or 005.
Like I said, you're 350 right now, you might want to turn in just 5 degrees, just in case. But once that needle starts coming in, make adjustments. To recenter it. So if it starts swinging quickly, take that into account.
Yep. And I can turn it just to see where.
Yeah, you can get an idea for radio. We're 90 degrees. Turn it back to about that 350.
It's alive?
Yep.
Okay.
Just maybe, yeah, you got a good correction in. It'll come back in. Yeah, it's starting to move. There you go.
Yep. Okay.
Now just make adjustments to pick it up.
Checklist. Lean.
As needed. It usually doesn't gonna do much up here.
You know,
we're only doing about 3,000. You're already getting a little rough engine right there.
Yeah. Fuel selector on both. I'm totally forgetting the acronym for it that I've got, but transponder, fuel selector, lights, and pitot heat as required. A little more, Rich.
Yeah, your engine temps were climbing. You got to the roughness and you left it there.
Okay.
Roughness means we're lean. We need to put it back.
Flaps up, climb power, mixture, lean, transponder, lights, pitot heat.
Climb.
What's up?
All right. So lights, what lights do we need?
Strobe, we don't need taxi anymore.
We don't need landing.
We don't need land.
I'll leave the rest off.
Feet to go. 7 miles to go.
Prescott Air Traffic, Cessna 60 Papa. Currently 8,200 feet, climbing to 8,500 feet, 5 miles from Drake on the 350 degree radio. Going to be doing a 12 DME North Arc. Prescott Air Traffic. How's your ball look?
Uncoordinated.
Why is it uncoordinated right now?
Because we're climbing, yep. And I don't have the right rudder in. P factor, and...
And now that'll increase our climb rate.
Yeah.
And you won't be fighting the aileron quite so much.
Yeah.
You might feel a little awkward, just probably because we didn't have the rudder in.
Alright, so at 11.5, we're going to turn in on, back here, about 270, about 260.
Okay. Are you still practicing the 5 T's? What are the 5 T's?
Time, turn, twist, throttle, talk.
Alright. Again, when we do these, you're saying, time, and you're verbalizing the actual number.
Yep.
So time, 30 seconds. Turn, 260. Twist, we can do a twist 10, once we're establishing the turn, go ahead and twist 10.
Yep.
Throttle, if we're at 85, we'll maintain. 85, so we'll say that, either climb, descend, or maintain, and then the altitude you're going to or maintaining. So maintain 85 or say descend 75. That way you're verbalizing, you know exactly what you're going to. And then talk, nothing to report. Unless ATC tells you to report something. Again, what is your cruise power? Pitch and power?
23 and 90 knots.
Okay. So we're going to be using that.
What's the 5.3 Cessna Photon Equator vehicle back?
Basically, you have your 23 power set,
yep.
And pitch for your altitude, make adjustments, and it should settle out to 90.
Yeah, it feels pretty good right now, just slightly bumpy.
Yeah, it might take a moment to settle out.
Yeah, I'm pretty much hands off right now.
Now, how's your altitude looking now?
Slightly
high,
slightly climb,
So you might want to adjust that trim a little, get it set and then adjust that trim a little bit.
So we're at 10 miles, getting ready to turn to right there, 260,
now,
stay on this heading.
When you hit 11.5, that's when the turn starts.
Yep.
Not after 11.5.
I know, that's why I'm getting ready now.
Exactly, that's why you prep the 5 T's before you get there,
yep.
And so you know what you're going to do, and then you do time, 30 seconds, you're waiting on the timer, you hit 11.5, hit it, turn.
Yep.
Then once you're stabilized in the standard rate turn, then you can finish the 5 T's.
Yep. And we're going to be turning the VOR, I'm going to be turning the dial to the left. I'm just checking,
okay.
Making sure which way I'm going to be turning the dial.
Yep.
So we're at 11.2, 11.3, 8,500, 11.4. And we're starting that turn, 30 seconds.
So turn.
Turn.
Where are you turning to?
260, time 30 seconds, turn 260.
twist.
Coordinated turn, twist, nothing right now,
twist
but
10.
Twist 10 right away?
Yeah, you can do that twist 10 right away when you're on the arc.
Twist 10.
Throttle.
Throttle's good.
But maintain 8,500.
You know. And talk, nothing to report.
Good job. So I want, that's what I want every time you change direction or altitude.
Yep.
I want to hear that.
I'm going to turn an extra 10 degrees already for the 0.3. It was a slow, it was a less than standard rate turn for sure. Yeah, 43.
Now if you're outside the arc, and you want to turn in. Right now it seems to be working, so don't overthink it.
Yeah, no, I turned another 10 degrees right away. I turned it inside.
Yep. But what is the general rule of thumb if you're outside the arc? How
many do you want to turn? 20 degrees.
Okay. Just so you know that.
Yep.
All right.
But yeah, the initial 90 degrees from it and then the 10, but we're back up to 0.2.
Okay.
0.1. Okay, we're good. We're cutting the circle.
All right. Keep your scan alive.
Yep. Turn 10, or twist 10. Turn 10, we'll go 240, and we're going to the 290 radial, so right about there.
The more you fly, the more you'll start to feel that.
Yeah. Alright, 11.8.
Prescott area traffic, Cessna 60 Papa, 8500. Doing 12 DME arc, 330 degree radio from Drake. Fucking mic. I like hold it in and pull it to the side.
Your button?
Yeah, so if you feel me tugging on you a little bit,
yeah, that's fine.
Just do what you gotta do, I'll try not to interfere too much.
I can try to make some radio calls too though.
Yeah, okay. I'll just tell you when to give a periodic position report.
Yeah.
Basically just tell them we're doing an arc and what radio we're on and the altitude.
Copy.
Feel that pitch down?
Yep, I felt that one. And I heard it too.
Yep, you can hear the engine change.
Yep.
In the helicopter, I could actually hold altitude and airspeed just off sound. You're overdoing it.
Yep.
Watch. Use your pitch, known pitch attitudes on the attitude indicator.
No. And I'm 11.6. I'm going to stay on this heading until we get back up.
That's fine. So pitch for level. And make adjustments from there. Your pitch below the horizon?
Yeah.
So your pitch down, pitch for level. A little harder at night.
It shouldn't be. It's not.
It's even harder, so even worse than the helicopter because you get mad false horizons.
Oh, yeah.
Because you can actually see down by your feet and you see the roads.
Yeah.
And it is wicked awful.
We're 11.5. Wow. All right.
So just, yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to maintain this heading.
And if it helps, look at where you are. Look what's 90.
How does that help?
That gives you an idea what the
what
course
the,
is.
What the zero.
So if we were on
what
track,
the zero gain thing.
You know, that would be a while where we should be on, but yeah, you're making a correction, that's fine.
Okay.
But it kind of gives you an idea. And again, with wind correction, that's not going to be exactly accurate.
Yeah.
But it gives you an idea.
Understood. Yeah, that's your zero gain.
That's your zero wind ideal heading.
We're back up to 11.6 anyway, so that's good.
Yep, keep letting it go.
We got 20 more radial degrees to go.
Right,
and
so
then we're turning outbound to the 16.
Yep, going outbound 16 DME.
So right turn, and then another right turn to 360.
Arc to the 360.
Yep. Temperature's good, fuel. Vacuum's high. It's in the green. 7.8. To make sure that one was working.
Positive rate.
Alright, we're on the 29.
Okay, now what are you doing?
Going up and down.
Going right back to where you were.
Is with you, 9,600 climbing, 10,000 at the ring.
He's at 4. Okay, at the ring, yeah. And we're at 12.3, I gotta turn. Okay. Once we get to that, we're turning to, we're gonna follow the 290 out.
Contact, I'm maintaining 2,000. What the hell did you guys request in Europe?
12.5, come on.
And climbing 12,000, answer 210, and rate will work for 94.
94, Roger. Climbing 13,000.
Copy 13,000, 94.
Now, when are you going to start your turn?
Two dots out. Or one dot for
it's up to you.
As far as
it's your judgment.
Copy. It's moving real slow because we're 12 miles out instead of 10.
Up the 5 T's.
Yep. Turn into 290. All right, time, 30 seconds.
Okay.
I'm going to start the turn now. 30 seconds.
Good, but we're staying away from it. We're still in the arc. I have to check the map. I just stay away from it.
Time, 30 seconds, turn, 290. 290, good, good. Talk, nothing to report. Throttle's good. Those two backwards.
Is the throttle good?
Throttle's good, but my pitch.
Maintain 8,500?
Yeah, my pitch is not.
So throttle maintain 8,500. We're not on it.
Okay,
so
throttle. Okay.
So that's why we're saying maintain. Okay. So your cue to check it and
yeah.
Go, oh, wait, I gotta
do I need more power? Do I not need more power?
Yeah, do I need to make a correction?
Sabi. All right. We're right on the 290. We're taking that out to 16 DME.
So let them know where we are and that we are going to be doing a north arc on the 16 DME.
Prescott traffic.
I'm at a 4 traffic, Albuquerque Center. One,
we're, yeah, we're just monitoring that.
Monitoring.
Prescott traffic.
24.
Radio from Greg. 14 miles out, 8,500. We're heading out to a 16 DME arc off of Drake. Prescott traffic, 6-0 Papa.
Alright, so 5.5, we want to start turning 90 degrees, and we're going to go to the 360. 90 degrees.
Now, when you make those adjustments, you can climb a little bit, but make just small pressure adjustments on the pitch.
That is good.
If you make a trim, make sure you're not over trimming it either.
Yeah.
Because sometimes, like in this aircraft, it may not take much trim to get it to pitch up a lot.
Yeah.
You've got to be really fine on that.
We're into the 020, 30 seconds.
Okay, so 30 seconds, you're ready on the timer?
Yep.
So here it comes, anticipating, holding everything. There's 15.5, start timer. Now the next turn.
Turn, 020, time, 30 seconds. I put those backwards. Throttle, I need more. Talk and maintain 8,500. Talk, nothing to report. Twist.
Do your twist 10.
Twist.
Now we're going back towards the north.
Yep. And less than standard rate turn. So again,
how can you fix that?
There we go.
Okay, now we'll see what happens to it.
Yep.
So it's bank and rudder at the same time to get that coordinated standard rate turn.
And we're already 0.3 out.
Okay.
Because of my turn again. So I'm going to go 10 degrees. Degrees, yeah, turn 10 degrees out already. Okay, so now we're heading back west to north arc. 16 DME. That's coming in. And we're going to the 360.
About engine night flying. Slight hiccup in the engine, you're like, what?
Yeah.
Again, slight pitches, so you're already there.
Yep.
So you gotta anticipate getting there. So you're not. Then pitch for level, and that should center out all on its own. Smaller inputs on the pitch. Steady it out. Kind of going up and down.
Still.
16.3, remember, on the outside of the arc, you might have to do a 20 degree correction.
No, yeah.
So keep that as your twist 10, turn 10, but then make your 20 degree correction off that. That way you know what to come back to if you once you get back on 16. Feel that? Pitch?
Yep. 16.2, so we're cutting the corner.
Okay. And it's okay if you cut through it and get down to like 15.9 and just hold
15.9. Yeah, I'm fine with that.
That way
yeah.
If you screw up, you're just going to go back right back onto the arc.
Yep.
And it's 0.1 is no big deal. That's well within tolerance. I got a little, there was a curve in the window, I thought some lights out there were moving, I'm like, crap, airplane.
Yeah, the window is pretty gummy.
Yeah, well, no, it's just when you get that curve in the plexiglass.
Yeah, that
distorts
too.
Distorts the image.
Fishbowl effect.
Yep.
Yeah, we're holding steady at 16.2.
That's looking pretty now.
Yeah, that's finally.
And if you want, give it like a five more degrees than what you hold, and it might slowly creep in too.
Yeah.
Twist 10, turn 10, but turn like 15.
Yep. Twist 10, turn 15.
Just remember, it's always harder to fix an outer
and outside
arc than inside.
You're finding the trend.
So it's always best to at least slowly creep in on it.
Yep.
There's 16.1, so yeah, we're nice. We're creeping in. It's good. Alright, so what are we arcing to?
360.
Okay.
Got it set here. How's our time? You're looking good.
Once we turn inbound, we're going to turn inbound off this one, then I'll vector you down towards the airport. So once we start descending, you can start getting ATIS whenever you feel like it.
Copy. I can start my what?
You can get ATIS and stuff once we turn inbound
gotcha.
And start doing all that.
Yep.
Whenever you feel like
getting
ATIS.
Yeah, 16 miles out is plenty of time.
But I'll start vectoring you down and in towards the airport and all that.
Yeah.
Now you got it back, so watch that pitch. Are you feeling it at all?
No, not really. Just very, very, very small.
That's not unusual. I mean, you don't really. Some people don't really start feeling it until CFI or even later.
I hear it before I felt it.
Yeah.
Like I heard.
I feel it.
Heard the RPMs increase. Yeah.
I'm just like, oh, the recliner. Oh, nose down.
Yeah, 15.7. So maybe we cut it to 15.6 now. I'm gonna keep this heading.
Yeah, for the next few turns.
For the next turn, for sure.
Yep. Okay. Just remember with your scan, no more than a few seconds on each thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, the faster you keep the scan, the less likely you're going to let something drift off.
It's keeping the scan and processing the information as quick as you can.
It's very.
It doesn't do any good to just go boop, 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 boop.
Without reading it, yep.
Yeah, without reading it, interpreting it, and processing what that means. So, yep, there's altimeter, yep.
But that's the thing about instrument, it's a lot of mental concentration.
Yep.
And after like an hour of cross country, you're like, are we there yet?
Yep, mentally fatigued, yeah.
Exactly.
All right, 15.5, hopefully we level out at that.
And when you're about to do the twist 10, turn 10, give them a report, 16 DME on that radial.
Okay.
For the arc.
Wait, say that again? Do you want me to do
as this comes into 330, we just give a position report.
Copy.
So we're doing the arc. That way they know where on the arc we are.
Yeah.
And it doesn't have to be exact, just gotta be close.
Yeah. Yeah, 55, it hasn't budged on that, so I'm thinking. Not gonna go any lower than that if we keep this heading.
Here, I'm gonna come on you with the pitch a little bit.
Okay.
So you just control bank and stuff. I'm gonna do pitch. Okay?
Okay.
So you maintain heading.
Put my hand on there, yeah.
And I'm just gonna play with the pitch.
Okay.
I'm gonna try to get us back to altitude. And trim it off, see if I can't get it to level.
Traffic 7660, Papa is on the 340 radio from Drake, 16 miles out. We're doing a 16 mile DME arc at 8,500, Prescott traffic.
How we're doing a slow descent?
Yep, yeah.
Nothing aggressive.
Just creeping that way a little bit.
Yeah, we just don't want to make abrupt movements on the pitch. 200 feet a minute is probably good, 300 depending on the altitude. Okay, there we are, so pitch back for level.
Yeah.
Adjustments, for level, trim.
What are you looking for? Oh, the trim. Nice. Looks good. 15.7. This 10. Turn 10.
Now, for the most part, if you get it trimmed off good, you get it your altitude, you get it trimmed off, even if there's slight bumps, for the most part, you should just be able to fly hands off.
Yeah.
For the trim, it might be a very slight input on the trim. Some aircraft are more sensitive than others. I prefer ones that are less sensitive because you can get real fine, real accurate with your trim.
Yeah.
Alright, so one more twist 10.
One more twist 10, and we're going to turn in at probably 1 dot. We're 16 miles out, so 1 dot. Damn, we should cover that much ground.
It's hard to read red on red.
Yes, it is. Your tenth of an hour is in red.
Yep. On this one, anyways.
I think it usually is.
Not all of them. Some is just the white with the black text. The rest are black and white.
Yeah. 15.9. 16.
Yeah, so we're looking good there. Altitude's pretty steady. It's fluctuating a little bit, but that's fine. Turn 10, and we're going to anticipate that turn on the final heading.
Yeah, just 1 dot, probably.
Well, how was it last time?
It was fine.
Okay.
It was pretty good. Once I turned back on it, it was within 1 dot, I thought.
Okay. Yeah, and if you're within 1 dot, that's fine.
Yeah.
But just use past experience. So like, oh, I turned it 1 dot, it was too much based on this DME, and okay, maybe next time I'll adjust.
Yeah.
You know? So.
Further out, it should be less sensitive, so.
But yeah, it should take longer, so you want to get closer. Whereas when you're closer, you're crossing radials faster, you want to start turn earlier.
Yep. 16.1.
Alright, so anticipate.
Yep, we got the clock set already. I'm gonna turn. What's up? I'm gonna head straight south. This is 90 degrees. No, we're taking the.
They're turning inbound, so turn to the right.
Yeah, we're taking 290 radial in. So, right? 290? No, 360, sorry.
360 heading. 180.
So 180, 180 radial in.
So,
reverse sensing.
Okay, anticipating, that's good.
So, 360, yeah.
So you're already at 1 dot, so. Time?
Yep. Time.
30 seconds. Turn.
Go.
Standard rate. Turn to 180.
Standard rate, 180.
Twist, nothing to twist.
Twist is good.
Throttle.
Maintain 85. 10-8-5 and talk, nothing to report. Maybe okay. A position report, heading inbound.
Alright, Cessna 6 Sierra Papa. Maintain 180 inbound. Send and maintain 7,500.
180 inbound, 7,500. 766 Sierra Papa.
So if we want to maintain speed, but we want to descend, say 500 feet a minute, about average.
23, 20, 18, we want 1,800
yep.
RPM.
And then maintain your pitch for airspeed. Oh, something like that, average.
Oh, that got quiet. 7,500 and 180. And we're not doing DME anymore. That should go down real quick. 170. We're following that, though.
Yeah, move. Rapidly we're descending?
Yep.
Might be because we're heavy, so make adjustments.
Yeah.
And we got Oscar.
Back 301 Hotel Charlie, Phoenix Approach Roger. Flagstaff wanted me to relay to you about 5 minutes ago.
That's something else, right? Yeah.
Suspect traffic 766 Sierra Papa.
And
we're going to.
Is on the 360 radio from Drake.
We
40 miles out, descending to 7,500.
Yeah, I don't know if the sweeper listens to Unicom or anything. I don't know anything about that portion of it.
Down here for a little bit, which is out. Cessna 6 Sierra Papa, continue descent down to 7,500. Turn right, heading 240.
Right 240 and 7,500.
766
Sierra Papa.
Thanks.
If it's less than like a 20 second turn, do you do the 5Ts? Or do you just go for
it? You can abbreviate real quick. You like
yeah.
Time. You just make an estimate 20 seconds. Turn 240. Twist on the twist. Throttle. Descend to 7,500. Talk on the report.
Copy.
So it's just you go through the 5Ts, but you just skip the ones that are irrelevant.
Yeah.
You just say nothing to report, nothing to twist, whatever. Maintain altitude, whatever. You still want to rattle them off, because the idea of the 5Ts is confirming that you're not forgetting something.
Okay.
And it also helps you with your scan while you're going through the transition.
Yeah.
I'm going to put in Prescott.
Altimeter 3009er. Visual approach in use. Landing runways 21 left and 21 right. Outbounds advise ground to direction of departure. Inbounds contact tower 125.3. Notice to airman. Taxiway, hotel, closed, except
you can remember this.
Advise on initial contact, you have Delta.
Delta.
Yeah, all I need is Delta.
So verbalize Delta?
Yeah, I'm yeah. Good.
And then as they right. Call the others, you just make the adjustments.
Delta 0353.
I just want the wind.
1906 visibility.
1906, good.
Temperature 1.
You got the current altimeter setting?
Nope.
Approach in use.
That's half the reason we do this.
One left and 21 right. Outbounds advise ground to direction of departure. Inbounds contact tower 125.3. Notice to airman. Taxiway, hotel, closed, except 24 service operations. Advise on initial contact, you have Delta. Prescott tower information, Delta 0353 Zulu. Wind 1906, visibility 10, sky clear. Temperature 16 at dew point minus 1. Altimeter 3009er. Visual approach in use. Landing runways 21 left and 21 right.
Niner.
Alright, we got Delta.
Delta.
Cessna 6 Sierra Papa, maintain 7,500. Turn left heading
180.
180, 7,500. 766 Sierra Papa. 5T is time. Less than 20 seconds. Twist.
5335.
Turn 180. Twist. Nothing to twist. Throttle. Maintain 7,500. Talk. Nothing to report.
134.5. Just keep doing. Every time we change the heading or altitude.
Yeah.
5Ts.
Yeah, that one was pretty smooth.
Yep. And it gets easier. And but the more you do the 5Ts, the easier it gets.
Yeah, it's also the flow, the muscle memory that I need to put with it. Time. Now. Time, turn, twist.
When you do them, you want to verbalize, if there's something like maintain
yep.
Or descend, you verbalize the exact number,
yep.
Because that's telling you, that's confirming that you have the
yeah.
Correct number,
talk on.
And it's also reminding you what to turn to.
Yeah.
So like, what was the heading? Oh yeah, 240, so turn to 240. All right, we're 13 miles out. At about 10. Inside 10. Give him a call.
Yeah, we're on tower now.
Not yet.
We're on ground right now.
COM 1. We're still on the practice frequency at the moment.
Yeah.
So until we get to like around the 10, then switch it over. And monitor tower and give them a call inside 10.
And
continue with the vectors.
Yeah, we're just 10 miles north of
northwest.
Right? Northwest? Okay.
About 152. 155. So 155, northwest.
Yep.
Be a full stop. How's the fuel looking? We'll leave that. We'll just leave it with that fuel. It should be good for them in the morning.
Yeah, plenty. Should be able to get two flights with it.
I think you had a solo student that you want to do accurate weight and balance for. Something like that. So you want to know exactly what the fuel is going to be.
$7,500, 180. Pressure's good. Center range checklist. Look at this quick. Descender range, fuel selector, both mixture, lights, comms and navs, altimeter. Fuel selector, comms and navs, we've got ATIS. That's back, altimeter's fine. Light speedo heat as required. Do we want land or taxi light on?
Wait until we're getting closer to the airport.
Yeah, maybe when we contact them.
Even inside, wait until we're inside their airspace.
Yeah, okay.
That way we're not flying around the head, the lights on. Flying.
Sounds good.
The landing and taxi are—that's where we're landing.
Yeah.
That's the whole point. It's just illuminating the ground.
Yeah.
Doesn't do us any good when we're up here.
They'd be able to see us from 10 miles out though with the light on, right?
Oh yeah, it would help. Okay. See us, but
I mean, not that.
We can think about. Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna switch over.
All right.
On tower, got cool. Delta. Just seeing if there's anybody else on the frequency.
Give it a second. Give you a turn real quick. Turn to 160.
Okay.
And give him a call.
160.
Prescott Tower 766 Sierra Papa is 10 miles northwest of the field with information Delta. Full stop.
Cessna 766 Sierra Papa, Prescott Tower, and right base runway 21 right, report 3 miles.
Right base for 21 right, report 3 mile final, 766 Sierra Papa.
Cessna 660 Papa, right base, 21 right, 3 mile base.
Right base for 21 right and 3 mile final, 660 Papa.
660 Papa, not final, sir, base, sir.
Okay, 3 mile base, okay.
Gotcha. 3 mile base, 660 Papa.
660 Papa, thank you.
Yeah, what they want is they want us to come in 3 miles on the base.
Gotcha.
And then in.
Yep.
Gotta be very attention to those little details. Because otherwise, what they'll tell us is enter a 3 mile final for 21 right.
Yep.
They won't tell us the right base.
Yep.
Yeah, they just want us to aim for the 3 mile final and join final.
Yeah, 21 right.
They want us to go to the base.
21 right
miles.
Should be a little different at night. I like that. That's good.
And they might push us over like they did before.
Yeah.
It's just there's some other traffic out here.
Yeah, I heard you guys coming in on live ATC.
Okay.
Yeah, I heard them do that.
All right, Cessna 6CR Papa, maintain present heading, descend and maintain 6,500.
Descend and maintain 6,500, maintain heading 160.
If it's present heading, it's not changed, it's just basically confirming.
Yep.
But at least make sure you say, you know, you respond with the change, so descend and maintain 6,500.
Yep. Okay.
With ATC, you want to keep it short. Sometimes they're going to give you some stuff, but you don't have to repeat it all back.
39, my clear request, stop and go.
Riddle 39, runway 21, left cleared, stop and go.
You got your... So we're 6 miles, so go ahead and get the landing and or taxi on. Help them with visibility.
Taxi light. Right. Put the landing on as well.
All right, Cessna 6CR Papa, turn left heading 140.
Left 140, time.
There's no time, it's too short.
Yeah, time, too short. Turning 140. Throttle is out to descend and maintain 6,500. Twist, nothing to twist. wants us to report 3 miles.
Yep. Alright, Cessna 60 Papa, go ahead and descend and maintain 6,000.
Down to 6,000, 60 Papa.
Go ahead, descend. Sierra Papa, turn left, heading 120.
120, 60 Papa.
Power 60 Papa, 3 mile right base for 21 right.
766 Sierra Papa, change to runway 21 left, number 2, follow Cessna, inside 1 mile final.
Change to 21 left, following Cessna, have Tufkin sight, 60 Papa.
Cessna 60 Papa, Cessna's a stop and go, runway 21 left, clear to land.
Clear to land, 21 left, 60 Papa. Alright, mind controls?
Your controls.
Go ahead and take your foggles off. So we got the aircraft over there on
yep.
final.
Got them.
You see the rabbits?
Yep.
Alright, your controls.
My controls.
Give me a normal landing. So.
Yep, it's already time.
So,
power 1500.
Don't descend too rapidly. You're good where you are.
Okay.
But get below 100, like 95 or less. Go ahead and put that first notch flaps in.
Blowing 10 flaps, 10.
Going to 80.
Down for 80.
Power out to, was it 12, 15, 15. And maybe anticipate that turn. If you
yep.
have to do a little shallow turn, that's fine. But you don't want to fly
yep.
past it.
Go to the threshold. Got it. And then he's a stop and go? Well, he better,
yep.
We got time.
He's fine.
Fly path's good. I'm going to put that second notch flaps
okay.
in. And
I'm
last.
Confirm
and
you're below 95.
In the white arc. 20 degrees,
and land
that's,
with,
and that's where we're staying.
Remember, land with 20 and go to 7, and
yep.
70 for short final.
Copy.
Alright, so see the lights, we're already low, so maintain, use the power.
Yep.
Maintain 70 knots and this altitude, so we get closer.
You want 70 knots and you want...
Oh, hold altitude,
yeah,
just add power altitude. To hold altitude. So we're still descending, bring in the power, so rest that descent. But I want to see 4 white lights.
Copy.
These, even lighter, they sink right through that glide slope.
Copy.
We want to be able to glide to the runway if the power...
Landing lights on.
Alright. So gas on both. Extra as needed.
Undercarriage fixed. Props fixed. Seats and seat belts.
Continuing to maintain altitude until we get those lights. When we pull the power, you'll come down. Maintain center line.
4 white.
Alright, 4 white. Power, gain 70.
Yep.
Can't really see, so kind of just use the VASI as your
yep.
aiming point.
A little bit more right.
So we're sinking below it, so. Remember, we're heavy, so it might take a little more power than normal to maintain that glide.
Yep. We're back on 4 white.
Alright. Alright, now when the threshold comes below the nose, that's when you start to pull the power, so let it come down. Slide, 1 sink. We're going to land a little further past the touchdown, that's fine. Alright, so slowly start reducing power.
We're at 75.
Switch back, slow, bring that power out. Oh, nice. Don't over control it.
Power is all the way out.
Alright. Hold, there you go, nice. Okay. Hold it back, slow it down, let it slow. Down, still on the brakes. Got an exit over here.
I see him. Yep, got it.
Six zero, Papa. Turn left, Delta 4, contact ground 0.7, good night.
Left on Delta 4 and switch into ground, see ya.